Hello Cloud Gurus, I'm Nigel Poulton, the author of the Kubernetes Deep Dive course video here at A Cloud Guru, and this is Kubernetes This Month, the show that keeps you right up to date with all the cool stuff going on in the Kubernetes world. Okay, first up, here are my five top Kubernetes news items from the past month. Google Kubernetes Engine announced its next generation managed Kubernetes with the announcement of Autopilot, which I actually think is pretty cool, so we'll dig deeper into that later in the deeper dive section. Now, in the service mesh space, Solo announced general availability of Glue Enterprise. That's their solution for simplified service mesh management based on Istio. Now, it's great news for Solo and Glue customers, but it's also another potential sign that Istio might be becoming the industry standard service mesh. Sticking in the service mesh space, the Linkerd project announced the Linkerd steering committee, which I think we'll look at again in the deeper dive section later. Switching to Kubernetes security, and Taigera announced the Calico Cloud. This is a SaaS platform aimed at Kubernetes security and observability. Basically, it's about policy enforcement, compliance, and observability of multi-cluster, multi-cloud environments. So, if you're doing Kubernetes in production, it is worth a look from a security perspective. And we'll finish the news off with another security-related announcement. Red Hat adds yet another string to its Kubernetes bow by completing the transaction to acquire StackRox. So, StackRox is a leading Kubernetes-native security platform that gives visibility and more than just features. Well, that is being acquired by Red Hat, which further bolsters Red Hat's OpenShift credentials, especially if you're a serious production Kubernetes user. And that, Cloud Gurus, wraps the news picks for this month. So for deeper dives this month, we'll look at GKE Autopilot and the Linkerd Steering Committee. So Google pretty much invented Kubernetes, and GKE has pretty much always been at the forefront of hosted Kubernetes innovation. Well, guess what? Here it is again, bringing us what could be hosted Kubernetes 2.0, or at least a glimpse of what it might look like. So we've already got GKE and a bunch of other hosted Kubernetes, and they do a cracking job of hiding things like the control plane and managing performance and availability and updates and all of that kind of stuff, right? But Autopilot is taking things to the next level. Yes, it's built on top of GKE, you just get way more of the hands-off stuff. So basically more of a fully managed solution. So you get a hands-off control plane, of course, yeah, but also hands-off nodes, hands-off security config, all kinds of stuff, right? Now, on the nodes front, Autopilot can optimize node config based on your workloads, potentially reducing your infrastructure costs. And then on the security front, it's basically security best practices by default. So you're getting GKE, but with a strong security posture at pretty much zero effort. And you know what? For a lot of companies, that's what they want. Pretty much saying to the Google Cloud, look, we trust your Kubernetes expertise. In fact, look, you almost certainly know more than we do. So just go ahead and provision and manage all of my infrastructure, yeah? Control plane, performance, availability, and now security, nodes, and more. You do all of that, leave me to focus on my apps. So that's GKE Autopilot, a glimpse of next generation hosted Kubernetes, and possibly a step towards a world where Kubernetes is just hidden in the background. Who knows? All right then, Linkerd. Now, there's a ton going on in the service mesh space, and there's a ton of complexity there. In fact, service meshes are pretty much known for their complexity, which is why Linkerd is almost unique. It stands out for its simplicity, and it's pretty much a service mesh for the minimalist. Well, guess what? It's the same for their new steering committee. Unlike other steering committees that serve the interests of a bunch of different groups, such as users and vendors at the very least, right? Well, the Linkerd steering committee is focused entirely on users. In fact, to be on the steering committee, you need to be running Linkerd in production at scale. So the blog post announcement says, and I'm quoting here, right? Members of the Linkerd steering committee must currently run a Linkerd production deployment of non-trivial size. So, no representation without productionization. Now, I'm not saying that Linkerd is the service mesh for you, but what I am saying is it's got a growing user base and it's way cleaner and simpler than many of the others. As well though, it's obviously a CNCF project and now it's got a solid, grounded steering committee. So I think a pretty bright future. Well, that's it for this month's episode of Kubernetes This Month. If you like the show, be sure to give it a massive thumbs up, yeah? If you've got a question, add it into the comments. Stay safe, and I'll be here again next month, so don't forget to subscribe. Same cube time, same cube place.